God, you that for God, but I'm back shit, back into the world. You looking at a former cocaine user. You looking at a former idolatrous. You're looking at one right here, but he saw the best in me. Oh God, and give them a sound mind in the name of Jesus. Yes. Oh God, if somebody's troubled in their home, in their marriage, in their children, oh God, we're praying for restoration.
Help them, Father.
In the mighty name of Jesus. God, we know that you are able, God. For your word tells us, ask and it shall be given, seek and ye shall find, knock and the door shall be opened. For everyone that asks receives, everyone that seeks they find, everyone that knocks you open the door of God. So we're asking in the name of Jesus that you would do this, oh God, that we may be complete as a people, oh God. And we'll continue to give your name the praise, the honor, and the glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I promise you I won't be before you long. As a matter of fact, this might take about 10 minutes. So but I want to talk about the process. The process. You know, life is all about process. We get our food. I think nowadays the food is processed. That's how we get our canned goods and things like that. When I decided to go into the military, there was a process for that. I had to go take a test to see if I qualified for it. After I passed the test, then I had to go take a physical to make sure that I was able to perform duties. Once I got past the physical part of it, I entered into the service, the Marine Corps, hoorah. For those Marines that might be in the house. But I had to go through basic training because I had to be taught what it was that the military expected from me. So I made it through boot camp, 12 long weeks. But I made it. And then I entered into the military world. And the rest is history. I did my 4 years, thank God for that, and I made it through.
Amen.
Even women have to go through the process when a child is being birthed. They have to go through a 9-month period. So, you know, the expected time is a 9-month period. And in that process, they have to go through all kinds of changes in their bodies. So I praise women for the strength that you all have. But God knew what he was doing because he knew that I'll come to him. So he chose women to do it. I thank him for that. Oh, we're going to keep it real. And in that process of 9 months, and let me take this time to say, if you don't believe in God, that should be enough right there to make you believe that there is a God and that he's working on our behalf. Because for a person to be able to carry another person inside, that just blows my mind every time I think about it. And to process that for 9 months, 36 weeks, and that child is being nurtured through you, that is awesome. That's the kind of God we serve. Someone who loves us more than we'll ever know. And so they go through that period, and then the child is born. And when the child is born, the child got to go through a process. Because he don't immediately come out eating steak and potatoes. He got to drink some milk. And so it is in our Christian journey. When we come to church and we join church and we get involved in church, we don't immediately just know everything. There's a process that we have to go through. Even in sports, and I love sports. Baseball is my thing. I really love baseball. Yes, sir. But in the professional sports world, they have seasons. In the NFL, they have 16 weeks of season. The NBA has 82 games. The baseball has 162 games. Hockey has 82 games. Those are the four major sports. And in the process of those seasons, they're playing each other to see who's going to be the best and who's going to make the playoffs. Because only a certain amount of teams can make the playoffs. So in the process, once you go through the season and you get to the playoffs for those that make the playoffs, then it becomes a process of elimination until the final two meet up, and then they battle each other to see who's going to be the best. So life is full of processes that we have to go through. And so in today's text, we find ourselves talking about Moses. And when Reverend Mel originally came to me and asked me to preach this Sunday, you know, I began to seek the Lord. And I said, Lord, what is it that you would have me to talk about? And my original text was the mountaintop. And you can just imagine how excited I was when I looked at the lectionary for the United Church of Christ and seen the scripture coming from Deuteronomy. And it was talking about Moses being on the mountaintop. I'm like, okay, Holy Spirit, I'm right there with you. I'm good. But as I began to fast and pray and seek the Lord for the message, God changed the message. Uh-huh. And he said, we're going to talk about the process. And I said, well, Lord, what that got to do with this scripture? Because that don't seem to line up with this scripture. But as the Lord began to lead me through the Spirit, he began to show me that, yeah, it lines up with it. You just do what I tell you to do, put it down on this paper, and you'll be all right. So that's what I did. I'm following the lead of the Lord. Hallelujah. So, like I said, we're not going to be here long. I'll probably be doing about 5 minutes. But I want to talk about this. Church, have you ever let someone or something bother you so much until you do something you know you had no business doing? Yes. But out of anger and frustration, you did it. Yeah. Knowing that God would be displeased with you. I've been told that when we allow emotions and actions to dictate what we do because of someone else, we give that person power over us. Because we react negatively when they push our buttons or rub us the wrong way. Whether we realize it or not, we do the same thing when it comes to the devil. We give Satan power and authority over us when we react out of anger and frustration, which is where we find ourselves at in today's passage. The children of Israel were finally about to enter into the promised land, a journey that was supposed to have taken 40 days.
Yes.
Ended up taking 40 years because of sin and disobedience. In today's text, we find ourselves coming to the end of Moses' life. Moses was the one chose to lead the children of Israel out of slavery from the hand of the Egyptians. The one who led them across the Red Sea on dry land into the wilderness. Moses was God's mouthpiece. Moses was the mediator between God and the children of Israel. But Moses disobeyed God in front of all Israel, and because of his disobedience, he along with his brother Aaron would not be allowed to enter the promised land.
Yes.
If you want the Hollywood version, watch the Ten Commandments starring Charlton Heston, who plays Moses. It comes on every year around Easter on ABC. But if you want the real version, you'll find it starting with the book of Exodus and running to the end of Deuteronomy.
Yes.
Moses had finally had enough of the children of Israel murmuring and complaining that in the book of Numbers, the 20th chapter, starting with verse 9, we find where Moses disobeyed God's orders to speak to the rock that it would bring forth water. But out of his frustration toward the children of Israel, Moses struck the rock twice. Moses was told to speak to the rock by God. Instead, he called the people rebels and said, shall we bring forth the water, implying that it was the work of Moses and Aaron to provide for the people? It was not. Rather, it was the Lord who would provide the life-giving water. And me and my wife was talking about this morning, and she said, wasn't Moses trying to do something? I forget the conversation. But the gist of the story is that I was telling her that even though we're in church, don't mean that we're not going to go through some things. Sometimes we're going to get frustrated and we're going to get out of line. That's because we're flesh. We operate out of this flesh. We got to live in this flesh. And sometimes we can get pushed, our backs can get pushed to the wall until we come out swinging. And sometimes, even as a Christian, we do things that we know are not pleasing to God. And I know I'm guilty of it. As a matter of fact, I had an incident at work a couple of weeks ago, Ron, you know, with Miss Daniels. and I snapped. And I know I felt bad afterward, but I did what I did because I was operating out of my flesh. And the thing is, we can't walk in the Spirit 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. And even the strongest of the strongest are going to have some weak moments. Which brings me to my first point. We must believe in the process of God. The children of Israel murmured and complained and said many times they were brought into the wilderness to die. Don't they know that if God was bringing them out of Egypt into the wilderness to kill them, he could have just did that at the rock when they were stuck at the Red Sea and they couldn't get across. He could have used Pharaoh's army to destroy them right there if he wanted to do that. Or he could have waited until they got in the midst of the Red Sea and shut up the waters. That's if he wanted to do that. But that's not the kind of God we serve. We serve a God that loves us more than we'll ever really know. Their problem was they didn't believe the process. Here's a people who saw God perform the plagues on the Egyptian, who saw Egypt's firstborn killed by the death angel because of the blood on their doorpost. The death angel passed by them. They saw the Red Sea open and crossed on dry land to the other side. When they got on the other side and they began to complain about being thirsty and hungry, God supplied water. God supplied manna. God supplied quail, which is like a roasted turkey or something like that. God was providing for them. Even in the midst of them being there, like I said, a 40-day journey took 40 years. But the Bible says in those 40 years, their clothes never got old.
Yes.
Their shoes never wore down.
Yes.
I think that if I'm in the midst of that, well, let me take that back. Because I'm in the midst of it in today's world. And yet we still complain and murmur against God. Sounds hard to believe, but it's the truth. God has a plan for each and every one of our lives. Just look at where we are today. We are living better than we've ever lived before in our history as African Americans. We're eating better than we ever have. We go to restaurants, sit down, and eat some, you know, Red Lobster got that Captain's Feast, I think it's called. You know, where you get the shrimp and the lobsters, the Ultimate Feast, the Admiral's Feast, that's what it is. And we're eating better than we ever have before. But yet we're not satisfied. We're not satisfied. Which brings me to my second point. We must trust the process of God. In the book of Jeremiah, the children of Israel find themselves in bondage again by the Babylonians because of sin and disobedience. God tells them, I know the plans I have for you. It's to bless you and not to harm you, to bring you to an expected end. God wants us to trust his process for our lives. Every day is not going to be sunny. Some rain must fall. That's how we grow. But when it rains, look at it this way. Water is a symbol of cleanliness. So consider it God cleansing us. Sometimes we have to be purged. Because when we come into this Christian walk, we have brought a lot of baggage with us. And God has to get rid of that baggage if he's going to be able to get his purpose through us, out of us. So we got to go through some things. That's how we build our testimony. The Bible says we overcome by the blood of the Lamb and by the words of our testimony. That's how we build our testimony, by going through some things. That's how we gain faith and trust in God, knowing that if God did it before, he'll do it again. Hallelujah. God wants us to trust his process for our lives. Like I said, every day is not going to be sunny. Some rain must fall. But when it is raining in our lives, look at it this way. Water is a symbol of cleansing. There are some things that has to be purged out of us if we are going to be everything God wants us to be. So don't despise when you are going through your trials and tests, because they come to make us stronger. In the book of James, the first chapter, verses 2 through 4, James was talking to the Jews, and he was letting them know that when you're going through some things, you have to count it all joy when you fall into many temptations. Knowing this, that the trying of your faith worketh patience. But let patience have a perfect work in you, that you may be perfect and complete, wanting nothing. Sometimes we are going to be tested, but it's only to build our faith and our trust in God. Which brings me to my third and final point. God is the process. And I want you to follow me as I go through this. In the book of Genesis, chapter 1, verses 26 through 28, God says, let us make man in our image and after our likeness. And let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth. Yes. So God created man in his own image. In the image of God created he him. Male and female created he them. And God blessed them. And God said unto them, be fruitful, multiply, and replenish the earth. And that's exactly what we're doing. And he said to subdue it. Then you turn to Isaiah, the 9th chapter, verses 6 and 7. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace there shall be no end. Upon the throne of David and upon his kingdom, to order it and to establish it with judgment and with justice from henceforth, even forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this. Stay with me. Then if you turn to the book of John, chapter 1, beginning at verse 1, you'll find these words. In the beginning was the Word. And the Word was with God. And the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was light, and the light was the light of men. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. And if you go down to verse 14, you'll find these words. And the Word became flesh. I said the Word. In the beginning was the Word. In the beginning was God. In the beginning was the Word. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. And we beheld his glory as the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. In case you didn't know it, I'm talking about Jesus. God is the process. God in his infinite wisdom took a part of himself and wrapped it up in flesh and became man in the person of Jesus Christ, who walked the earth for 33 years preaching and teaching the kingdom of God. Everything that we have gone through or will ever go through in the future, Jesus has already gone through it. That's why scripture tells us that the Lord can be touched with the feelings of our infirmities. Jesus was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and by his stripes we are made whole. When God created man, he was not sinful. But because of Adam didn't trust the process of God, he disobeyed God, causing separation from God. But God in his infinite wisdom decided to leave eternity and enter into time to redeem all human beings. God had chosen Israel as his special people, and there was a process by which they would have to go through. Because they were going to be the standard of excellence that the world would see and understand that Israel's God was God of all gods. It's the same thing today. When someone walks the aisle on Sunday morning to give their life to the Lord, they don't automatically know what to do. There's a process by which God will strengthen their faith, and it begins with Sunday school and Bible study. That's what we learn about God and who he is and what his purpose is for our lives. Church, God is trying to prepare us for something we cannot handle right now. You know, Erica Campbell got a song out, a popular song out that says, I need just a little more Jesus. I love the song. I listen to it every time I get a chance. But the truth of the matter is, Jesus needs a little bit more of us. Truth of the matter is, Jesus needs a little bit more of us. He's calling us to be the light of the world. The salt of the earth. A city set on a hill that cannot be hid. Just like Moses, when we give our lives to the Lord, we become God's mouthpiece. And God wants us to be a witness in this world, because there's so much going on in our world today. People are falling by the wayside by the thousands and the millions. Young girls are being snatched up in sex trafficking. Young boys are being snatched up in sex trafficking. People are shooting on the expressway. We got natural disasters, you know, earthquakes and things. I mean, things are just in bad shape. And God, I believe in my heart of hearts, is trying to get his people to wake up and realize that he wants to use us. This is a time for the Christian family to stand up and be that beacon of light in the world today. We were talking about it in Sunday school about, you know, being an example to the world. And I know I got some coming up to do too. This message is for me first. And God was dealing with me hard. Because I clown sometimes on my job. I mean, they know I can act a fool sometimes, but it's all in love. And I try to be respectful, but I play my Christian music, don't I, Ron? But God is calling us to this. And he's calling us to get ready. Because he wants to use us.
Yes.
And there are some times that we're not going to want to do it. But that's the time that we need to dig in deep the most and give it to God.
Amen.
Because he can do something with it. Like I said before, God has brought me a mighty long way, and I'm grateful for that. And I've dedicated my life to serving God. It doesn't matter what I have to go through anymore. And I'm happy about it. It ain't begrudging. I'm glad to do it.
Amen.
I thank you. I praise God for you all showing up. I hope that this message can reach the heart.
Yes.
Because only God knows.
Yes.
God bless you.